Welcome back to another unboxing episode of Filipino Time. Today we are back looking at another rising micro brand that is taking over the indie watch industry with their creative colorways for their second generation bi-compacts model. This is Studio Underdog. So, first things first, we have the box. Let's just take out this sleeve. And we have this pretty simple box with their brand name on it. We lift this and we are greeted with this very nice leather pouch with their brand once again. We also have this envelope which consists of the additional bracelet, so more on that later. And of course, your papers. And there you have it. So here we have the strawberries and cream model. Okay, so quickly for the dimensions, we have a 39 millimeter diameter. It's around 14 millimeters thick and features a 20 millimeter lug width for the strap and the bracelet. Now, once again, this is the strawberries and cream edition. So, Studio Underdog mostly takes inspiration from food with their other models consisting of watermelon, pumpkin, and even mint chocolate chip ice cream. So the whole point of Studio Underdog is to give more color and life to watches as an everyday lifestyle, where they believe life shouldn't be dull and boring. And so they give these brave colors and odd proportions in their models that give off just the right amount of goof. So, obviously with this model, you have the motifs of strawberries and cream with the strawberry red dial and creamy accents. Then, if you look closely, you can see that you get a fruity texture on the dial along with strawberry seeds along the edge. Now, the two sub-dials opposite each other at 3 and 9, one's bigger than the other. The right counts every minute, while the left counts the seconds. So the right has a creamy motif with the shade getting darker after every third of the sub-dial, surrounded with its own railroad design. The hand on this sub-dial is tipped with a pinch of green, of course reflecting the green leaves of a strawberry. For the left sub-dial, it gets this ring pattern, although it's also still surrounded with a railroad design. Now, despite having a second sub-dial, the watch still has a primary seconds hand, once again with a green tip. Now for the text, we have the brand and model name, which are asymmetrically placed, although they still give a bit of balance on the dial, which is probably due to the already asymmetrical sub-dials. Now at the bottom, we have mechanical hand winding. So the case is stainless steel, and it comes with both a beige calfskin leather strap, which you see here, and as I mentioned earlier, a Milanese mesh bracelet that was packed in the additional envelope. And here we can see that they are quick release, so that's pretty cool. So as for the crown, it's not screwed down, but it does come with the Studio Underdog logo. So this zero, the story is that the founder just decided to be creative in the sense of when creating a username online, for example, where people used to mix numbers and letters to make it a little bit more creative. And that's how he came up with the zero in underdog instead of the usual O. So for the buttons, the same as every other typical chrono, we can start the seconds hand, pause, and reset. For this really domed crystal, it's actually sapphire already. And overall watch is water resistant up to 5 ATM. We also get this clear case back that shows the Seagull manual winding ST1901. And around that, you can see how Studio Underdog pieces are actually made and assembled in Great Britain. So here we have it on my 7-inch wrist. Very funky, very creative, and this is sure to catch the attention of others. As for the loom shot, as always, we will present it by the end of this video. So with that, thank you for tuning in. We hope you enjoyed this episode. Please feel free to like, subscribe, and comment what you think about this watch. Thanks, and we'll see you next time.